Steps to restore a piece of Taylor County history are underway, partially because of a $50,000 grant from the Texas Historical Commission.
And Taylor County commissioners are adding $5,000. The old Taylor County Courthouse will look like new, but still look old. KTAB's Claire Kreitz explains in tonight's Eye on Abilene report.
Sitting across from the Taylor County Courthouse is a building that's gone relatively unnoticed for the last 30 years.
I'm not sure until I moved into this building, until I came to work here, that I passed it, I don't know how many times, and I'd never seen the building, even though I saw it. I'd never really looked at it and saw the beauty that it has.
Built in 1915, the building has withstood the hands of time, but it's seen better days.
We've done a lot of stuff to it over the years, and a lot of offices have changed and things such as that.
Now plans are in place to bring this historic Abilene landmark back to the forefront.
We want our citizens to have an idea of what life was like back when that was the center point of the downtown area, was that courthouse.
Starting with a $50,000 grant to update the master plans.
The architect has been picked. He was in a couple of weeks ago. He's been collecting old photographs, things such as that, so that we know exactly how these courtrooms looked back then and what the building looked like back in 1915 when it first opened its doors.
Next, the county commissioners and county judge will move their offices and courtrooms from the new courthouse over to the old courthouse and making room for a potential new CPS court.
Every step along the way, there are things that you get points for in the process of the state deciding whose courthouse is going to get updated and whose is not.
A process that could send this building back in time.
It's a part of Texas. It's a part of Taylor County. It's a part of who we are. You know, could it be torn down and something built bigger and better? Bigger, maybe better. No way. Not in my lifetime.
In Abilene, with coverage you can count on, Claire Kreitz, KTAB News.
All right, thank you, Claire. Great story there. The full project will take close to $8 million from another grant, but this first step is just the beginning.